Hey guys, thank you for finally letting me hit 100 subscribers. Let's see if we can get higher than that and even beyond that. Check out all my other videos from AMVs, music videos, my gameplays, and my story times. And let's get it on the video. Hey guys, this is your boy Malik on Fleet 3.0, back at it with another video, and this is the top 6 moments in anime that will piss me off, that it pissed me off, and I hope you enjoy it.
Tatsumi, saigo made, issho ni tatakaitakatta kedo, otoko ga meso meso suru nja nai wa yo. Watashi, Tatsumi no koto suki ni natte yokatta.
Alright, I put Mine's death, you know, from Akame ga Kill. See, I hated how everybody actually died in Akame ga Kill, the anime. Because when I found out that Mine survived and Tatsumi survived, unlike in the anime when they both died and Akame was the only one alive, that they were both alive and healthy and got married. See, everybody's death in Akame ga Kill, the anime, you know. It hit me because, you know, it felt like family. But Mine's death, you know, it just struck a certain chord. Because I wouldn't, like, you know, this is back when I was, like, I wouldn't say just getting into anime, but I was getting used to the tropes and how everything was working. And when I saw this anime, and I saw Mine, and I always thought when you see the main character and his girl, you know, they always make it at the end of the day. You know, love conquers all. But when I saw this, when Mine actually died, and after when I finish an anime, I always go to the fandom and see what happened in the manga, you know, in case they like left stuff out that I didn't see in the anime. And I found out that she was alive. Not only that she alive, and that she met and married Tatsumi, like they was going to do an anime, but they killed her off for some godforsaken reason. Like I just don't understand why they killed her off. And it just like hit me because all I could think about like for like the past week after I watched this anime, I was like, I can't believe they really killed Mine. Because Mine, I wouldn't say she was like my favorite character, but I was used to her. Like I started liking her because, you know, when she started out, she was kind of a bitch. But I got used to it. She was a tsundere, right? And I was like, okay, her and Tatsumi going to get together because, you know, they started showing some signs. I'm like, okay. And then they killed her off. Like, what kind of BS is this, bro? Like, are you serious? You killed her off for what? Like, for what?
Usotsuki. Omae, doushite?
Anta no koto mukai ni kita no. Henna usotsuku shi.
Coming in at number 5, I'm pretty sure I talked about this anime before in, I think, First Love versus New Love. Bro, I have no words for this scene, bro. A town where you live, when Asuka finds out the truth about what this, I forgot the main character's name, was doing. So, in the beginning, he was in love with this girl that he moved to this town just to find this one girl that he was in love with. And that's because she was, you know, she was a supporting character. That's the one of the people he first met going to the new town. And see, what makes me angry about this scene altogether, this anime altogether, is that Asuka did not deserve this, bro. She was a supporting character. Yo, I would not have felt anything for this girl if they just kept her that way. Because when they did that time skip and she came back and she was the girlfriend of the main character, Bro, I felt something because, you know, when they show you the scenes when the main character and her are together, yo, you felt like that was a great relationship. And you don't see any reason for them not to be together because she was A1, A+, God tier girlfriend, bro. She understood everything. She didn't get jealous like that. Even if she did, she would tell him, but she won't stop him. Bro, I mean, she did make some dumb mistakes leading up to why they broke up because she let him do certain things. I mean, he didn't cheat or anything, but she let him do something as long as he came back to her. But it just like, it hit me, bro. Because when I saw this scene, I'm like, I knew he was going to get caught. As soon as he said, oh, I'm going to my hometown to see my family, which the girl that he first fell in love with said that she was going to, but his Asuka did not know that the girl that he loved, his first love, was there. So I don't blame her for not knowing. But what irritates me is that the boyfriend, the main character, why didn't he just go with Asuka? Because Asuka went to go see her grandma, which I don't understand why he didn't just go with her, because that would have made a lot more sense. Yeah, y'all didn't go to that trip that y'all wanted to go to, but y'all could still hang out, even though it was taking care of her grandma. But instead, he goes to his hometown to see his parents, knowing that his first love is there, knowing that something could happen. And then when something did happen, they went to a festival together. Now, Asuka literally shows up out of nowhere because she finally helped out her grandma. She checked her up and everything. And she came early, you know, just to surprise her boyfriend, which is understandable. And this nigga really came back to the house. She called him first, okay? She called him first. She's like, hey, where are you and what are you doing? You know, to check up. Normal stuff. And this guy said, oh, I'm at home. Bro, when he shows up to his house and she's sitting right there, bro, I was so weak and I was so sad that they broke up, and she was very sad about it, man.
してほしいんだ。え?今まで君と吉沢君にあげてたお金。勝弘君。俺が殴られると、お金取られると、千鳥の心が痛いって知らなかったんだ。それに、今はもう千鳥だけじゃない。俺が痛いと、みんなが痛いから。
Number 4. It's Kaznaiver. Everything about Kaznaiver annoyed me, bro. Like, after like a certain episode and they started feeling each other's pain, bro, I could not stand this show. I still watched it, don't worry, I still finished the entire series. But bro, I just like, I felt it, like I felt like I was feeling their pain, whatever they're feeling. Bro, I just could not stand watching this show. Like everything, every moment will make you mad because you're rooting for one person, but then if you root for this person, you're hurting the other person, and you can't pick a side. You cannot pick a side, and then when you do, it hurts the other side. Yo, like this show, it was so complicated. Like, I did not know what to feel at a certain time of the show. But I do know one thing, Chidori, bro, she was like the worst character in the show. I ain't gonna lie, because she liked the main character, Kachan. I mean, and the guy in the pink hair, I forgot his name, Tinga, something like that. He liked her, and the short girl liked Tinga. Kachan liked the silver-haired girl, bro. It was just like a complicated mess. Like, I just didn't understand how to feel at any given time. Like, they will throw me for a loop literally the next episode. Like, I'm not going to tell you not to watch Kaznaiver, but unless you're ready for a trip, I wouldn't recommend it to you.
Satoru!
な。
I ain't gonna lie to you, I felt betrayed when I saw that moment, bro. When Kaio came back after Sutaru has been in a coma for like 15 years, and she came with a whole child. I never felt so hurt watching that moment. Like you'll say like, Malik, shouldn't you be happy for her? Cause you know, in the race, you know, she was destined to die, but Sutaru saved her. I'll say yeah, but in hindsight, like during the series, Sutaru and Kaio, when he went back in time, they were very tight. Like, yo, you can see some sparks happening, and the whole mystery, romance, and everything. Like, you felt that, like you felt the connection with the two of them, and you felt like over time they're going to get together after Sutaru saves everybody he's supposed to save in the past. Boy, was I wrong, because I guess the Arthur, I forgot what his name is. I guess he wanted her to wanted him to get with that one girl that he met in the present before he went in the past, which I understand, but I did not care for it because Kaio and him were so cute together when they were little, bro. And then you expect them to get together because you saw so much development with the two of them, like how close they were. And then just for this man to wake up from a coma after saving everybody, for her to show up with a kid. And not only did she show up with a kid, okay, she showed up with the kid of his best friend, one of his childhood friends that whom he saved. I was so weak. I'm like, wow, I saved your life just for you to knock up the girl that I wanted to get with. Like, that's exactly how I felt. Like, I felt that. Like, when I saw that, yo, I almost turned off, erased, bro. Like, that moment alone almost ended the series for me. That moment alone ended the series for me. Just right there. Like, I just did not know how to feel about that moment. Like, I just felt angry. I felt sad. Like, this man started crying when he saw her, like, hey, I'm glad you're alive. But in my mind, I'm like, I'll be crying, but for some other reason, because you really got pregnant by one of my best friends. It's kind of crazy. Like, I don't know how to feel about that. Like, if you watch it, you understand. Like, I'm telling you, just watch the series and you see what's happening. Because me telling you right now, you don't understand. But watching the series and see what everything has happened, oh yeah, you're gonna feel some type of way watching this series.
ここだ、ナギサ、ここにいるぞ。聞こえるだろう、俺たちの子供の泣き声。
はい。
ほら、最初に抱いてる俺。
はい、可愛いです。
俺たちの子だぞ、牛尾だ。女の子だ、元気な女の子だぞ。
はい、お家で産んであげられてよかったです。しおちゃんには大変な思いをさせてしまいましたけど。
I honestly don't think you felt pain until you watched the entire Clannad after story, which is the sequel to Clannad the first season. Look, watch Clannad the first season. It's boring, you know, it's typical. It's just like, it felt slow. You got used to the characters, but you know, it felt so slow. But get the Clannad after story, bro, you will never have felt so broken in your entire life, bro. You will feel depressed after watching Clannad after story. Like, I can't put it into words. Like, I cannot spoil it, and I cannot even spoil the show for you. You have to watch it yourself to understand the pain I felt watching this. Like, my friend Alex, after I watched this, And I told him about it, and he's like, should I watch? I'm like, yo, if you want to watch it, you want to feel some type of way. Like, you're going to feel pain. You want to feel something that you never felt in your entire life. Like, you think you felt pain now? You think you've been depressed? Watch this series, bro. Watch this series. This season, Clan of Ass Story. Watch that. And you'll feel pain, bro. Everything that you talked about, like, yo, I hate my family, I hate my mom, I hate my dad, I hate my siblings. Bro, watch Clan of Ass Story, bro. That would change your whole point of view, bro. Like, I cannot tell you enough. You watch that, yo, you will cry watching that scene. Actually, it's two specific scenes in Clan of Ass Story that will break you. But Clan of Ass Story, it was great. Like, I love it. Bro, I never want to feel that way again in my entire life. Like, I do not want to ever feel that way, because it left me broken. Like, after I watched it, bro, I high key wanted to drop anime for the rest of my life. Like, I did not want to watch another show. I don't care if it was action shonen. I don't care what kind of anime you try to offer me. I did not want to watch it after I watched Clan Ad. And then when I did watch anime, yo, I stayed away from anything that had to do with sad stories, bro. Like, if my friend like, yo, you should watch this, bro, this will give you a heart a jerk, I'm like, yo, I'm gonna stay away from that. Because after watching Clan of Ass Story, bro, I don't want anything to do with sadness. Like, it broke me. And until you watch it, you will never understand how I felt after watching the show.
Kokoro-chan, ano sa, kore kara mo ore Kokoro-chan no saikou no partner de irareru you ni ganbaru kara sa. Dakara kore kara mo zutto partner de iru tte yakusoku shite kurenai kana?
Ii yo, yakusoku suru.
Ii wa, yarimashou. Hoka ni wa?
Mitsuru-kun to tamesase te kudasai.
Ee, Kokoro-chan, datte yakusoku tte.
Man, before I say anything about this, I'm gonna let this guy speak for me real quick, and then I'll get right back to you.
Alright, so in the last video, we talked about Ichigo, aka Ichiho. But like I said in the last video, she will not be going to the streets alone, because Kokoro is going with her. My god, Kokoro, or should I call her Kokoho, is a thought. Yo, like, after what she did to my dude right here, I wanted to cry. My soul got ripped out of my heart. They even made a promise, too, that they were gonna stay partners. Shit. She said, fuck your promise. I'm switching.
Nani?
Look at her. She has no guilt. She left the nice guy in the group to the dickhead in the group. Come on now. Big boys need love, too. Damn. Just a sad reminder that nice guys finish last. So Kokoro and Mitsu would start to get all jiggy and shit, right? And the moment she figured out about the woohoo, she was like, I'm trying to fuck. And voila, Kokoro became 15 and pregnant. Like, damn, didn't even make it to 16 and pregnant. My god, Future take her ass too.
She belongs to the streets. She belongs to the streets.
Honest to god, I can't even say more than what he just said. Like, when I saw that scene, I was like, are you kidding me? Like, it happened, all that happened in the same episode. And I'm like, okay, you know, that's kind of cute. They made a promise. Yeah, they're going to stick together forever. And then she legit turned around and said, yo, I'm trying to switch, bro. This fat ass over here think I'm about to be with him for the rest of my life. Ha! He think this is a game. No, I'm trying to have a future. I'm not trying to have a future with chocolate bars. Like, are you kidding me? Like, you know how disrespectful that moment was? Like, I felt, like, disrespected myself. And I wasn't even the guy who got hit like that. And I'm like, you really did my dude dirty. Like, I can't say anything more about that. Like, after that, and then she got pregnant. She was the first one to get pregnant out of the entire group. The first child of the new generation. As a 15-year-old, like, she read this book and found out about sex, and she's like, yo, let me try that. Like, let me hit that. And not only that, she kissed Mitsuru. I think that, yeah, Mitsuru, later on in, like, I think an episode later, after cutting his hair. And I'm like, yo, when did this happen? When did y'all connect? Like, this caught me off guard. And then not only that, when they caught me off guard, I felt even more disrespected. What can you do? Like, after that, I was just like, And then Darling the Franks went downhill after that, you know, at the episode 15. We all know about that. I hope you enjoyed that video. Like and subscribe. And if you want more, just, you know, show me some love on the channel. Share it and give me a lot of views and a lot of likes. And I'll make another video similar to this, or I can make a part two. And if you have any moments in anime that, you know, annoyed you, you know, just slide in my DMs. Hit me up. And I'll try to make another video. Malik on Fleet 3.0 out.